Hi, welcome to my real-time operating system concept videos. In this video, I have tried to simplify and demonstrate inter-thread synchronization mechanism in an embedded system with the help of a producer-consumer example. To understand how to synchronize between two threads properly using a binary semaphore, let us understand this producer-consumer example, where one thread is controlling one robotic hand and second thread is controlling another robotic hand. The entire process should be so synchronized that only after a producer thread produces, the consumer thread should start consuming. And this should happen continuously n number of times. Consider this scenario where if there is a little mismatch in the synchronization between two hands, then the consequence can be seen here. This is why a correct sync is very much required. Before creating threads and understanding how two threads can be synchronous in an embedded system using any real-time operating system, let us first understand a little bit of types of semaphores. There are basically two types of semaphores, a binary semaphore and a counting semaphore. And a binary semaphore can be further classified into a mutex and non-mutex. The use or application of a mutex is to guard a resource between two threads, popularly called as resource locking between two threads. I have demonstrated a mutex semaphore with great examples and animations in my other videos. So, whereas a non-mutex binary semaphore can be used for signaling purposes between two threads, which is popularly called as inter-thread synchronization. Any real-time operating system provides APIs, application programming interfaces, or function calls to create a semaphore, acquire a semaphore, release a semaphore, etc. A binary semaphore has two values only, 0 and 1. 0, which means semaphore is not available, and a thread which tries to acquire this semaphore gets into block state or waiting state. And when the semaphore is released or it is made available, meaning the value is 1, the thread which was blocked comes out of waiting state and gets into ready to run state. Now let us understand by writing some code. Let's create a main thread which creates or spawns two threads. One being a producer thread and another being a consumer thread. Okay, so main thread calls an RTOS API to create a semaphore. And when a semaphore is created, RTOS returns a semaphore ID. Let us collect it in a variable sem_id and declare it. And while creating a binary semaphore for the purpose of synchronization, it is very important to understand that the semaphore has to be created with its initial state as not available. The semaphore is not available, which can be passed as an argument to the function or the API. Now create a consumer thread with a priority 20. Okay, so note that higher the number, higher the priority. Okay, let us consider this. Different RTOSs have different terminologies. So here we will consider higher the number, higher the priority. So let us create a consumer thread with a priority 20. Create thread API of any RTOS. Returns a thread ID to identify that particular thread. So let us collect it in a variable thread ID and then create a producer thread with selecting its priority as 10, which is lower than the consumer thread. So note that we have created two threads, consumer thread with higher priority and producer thread with lower priority. Okay, now since consumer thread is of higher priority than producer thread, consumer thread starts running because it is of high priority. So in consumer thread, put it in an infinite loop or loop it n number of times based on how many times you want to consume or produce. It depends on the application. Now the very first thing consumer thread does is acquire the semaphore, which was created by the main thread. Acquire the binary semaphore. And since semaphore was created with its initial state as not available, consumer thread, trying to acquire this not available binary semaphore, gets into blocked state. The red highlighted instructions are the instructions to consume based on what your application is. So actually, the actual consumption happens here. But these consume instructions will not execute because the consumer thread gets blocked at this point, since it is trying to acquire the semaphore and it is not available and cannot execute further. Therefore, cannot run the consume instructions. Now, since consumer thread, which is high priority thread, is blocked, the producer thread, the low priority thread, starts running. Producer thread starts executing produce instructions. And once the production is finished by this thread calls semaphore release API. So as soon as semaphore is released, which means the state of semaphore is now available, the consumer thread, which was blocked, gets into ready to run state. Now note that as soon as high priority thread, that is consumer thread, is ready to run, producer thread stops running at this point and consumer thread starts executing from the point it was stopped, from the point it was blocked. This switching from low priority thread as soon as high priority thread gets into ready to run state is called preemption. In other words, high priority thread has preempted low priority thread. So consumer thread resumes execution from this point and starts consuming. I mean, the consumer instructions gets executed. Also at this point, please note the state of the binary semaphore. Since consumer thread has successfully acquired the semaphore it was waiting for, the state of semaphore is again not available now. So this is one complete producer-consumer cycle. A non-mutex binary semaphore is acting like a signaling instrument. Now let us see how second cycle works. So once consumer thread is done with executing consumer instructions, and since this thread is in a while loop, it loops back and again tries to acquire the semaphore, which is in not available state, again gets into blocked state at this point. So now since high priority consumer thread is blocked, producer thread can now run, which was in ready to run state but couldn't run earlier because of its low priority. So same cycle continues, where producer thread produces and calls semaphore release so that consumer thread gets unblocked and starts consuming. In my next video, I have tried to simplify and demonstrate synchronization between a thread and an interrupt service routine, ISR. Please watch and do subscribe to my channel, and please comment for the feedback. Thank you. Thanks for watching.